In all of Earth's history, there have been 5 events where more than 50% of life died out, which is a big deal. The Ordovician-Silurian mass extinction. Around 443 million years ago, at the end of the Ordovician period, a major mass extinction occurred. In fact, the Ordovician-Silurian extinction was the second worst mass extinction in the planet's history. Just because it came in second, however, don't imagine that it wasn't that serious. The loss of life in this event wasn't far behind the leading mass extinction. The Ordovician-Silurian extinction was almost twice as severe as the KT extinction event that occurred at the end of the Cretaceous period, about 66 million years ago, which is famous for bringing an end to the dinosaurs. The brachiopods and bryozoans were decimated, along with many of the trilobite, conodont and graptolite families. Each extinction pulse affected different groups of animals and was followed by a rediversification event. The extinction was a most likely a result of global cooling and reduced sea levels, which dramatically impacted the many marine species living in warm shallow coastal waters. The Devonian mass extinction. 365 million years ago. A variety of causes have been proposed for the Devonian mass extinctions. These include asteroid impacts, global anoxia, widespread dissolved oxygen shortages, plate tectonics, sea level changes and climatic change. It was the age of fish. Throughout the oceans, species began dying out, and by the time it was all over, between 79% and 87% of all species had gone extinct, including Dunkleosteus. It was one of the worst mass extinctions in Earth's history. Numerous brachiopods became extinct, conodonts all but disappeared, and only one family of trilobites survived. The Permian mass extinction. 250 million years ago. Permian extinction, also called Permian-Triassic extinction or End Permian extinction, a series of extinction pulses that contributed to the greatest mass extinction in Earth's history. The Permian extinction was characterized by the elimination of over 95% of marine and 70% of terrestrial species. New research from the University of Washington and Stanford University combines models of ocean conditions and animal metabolism with published lab data and paleoceanographic records to show that the Permian mass extinction in the oceans was caused by global warming that left animals were unable to breathe. At the end of the Permian period, volcanic activity on a massive scale in what is now Siberia led to a huge outpouring of lava. Many families of brachiopods, gastropods, bivalves, and marine reptiles became extinct. On land, a great part of the vertebrate fauna disappeared at the end of the Triassic, although the dinosaurs, pterosaurs, crocodiles, turtles, mammals, and fishes were little affected by the transition. The Triassic mass extinction. 210 million years ago. The cause of the end Triassic extinction is a matter of considerable debate. Many scientists contend that this event was caused by climate change and rising sea levels resulting from the sudden release of large amounts of carbon dioxide. An increase in atmospheric CO2 caused acidification of the oceans and global warming that killed off 76% of marine and terrestrial species on Earth. On land, there was significant turnover as terrestrial life also took a massive hit. All Triassic archosaurs, apart from dinosaurs, pterosaurs and crocodiles, went extinct. All major groups of marine invertebrates survived the extinction, although most suffered losses. Brachiopods, shelled cephalopods, sponges and corals were particularly hard hit. On land, casualties included the phytosaurs, a group of crocodile-like animals. The Cretaceous, Tertiary extinction. 65 million years ago. The Cretaceous-Tertiary extinction event, or the KT event, is the name given to the die-off of the dinosaurs and other species that took place some 65.5 million years ago. The impact hypothesis states that an asteroid hit Earth, sending a cloud of dust and debris into the stratosphere, blocking out the sun, stalling photosynthesis and killing plants. The impact hypothesis is widely considered to be the cause for the Cretaceous-Tertiary mass extinction. Around 75% of Earth's animals, including dinosaurs, suddenly died out at the same point in time. The KT boundary separates the age of reptiles and the age of mammals, which was first recognized over 100 years ago by geologists who realized that there was a dramatic change in the types of fossils deposited on either side of this boundary. Thank you.